What's up? This is your boy, He Didn't Succeed. I want to talk about Floyd Mayweather and the conspiracy that I believe is true, very true. Floyd Mayweather has not selected a venue for his fight with Marcos Maidana. And the reason, you know, if you look at Mayweather's history of venues, it's always been MGM Grand. I mean, the last time he fought somewhere else was when he was building up his career and he was fighting in Detroit. Ever since he got a deal with MGM, he starts fighting there. He gets paid to fight there. They give him millions of dollars to fight there. Now, the issue that has come up is that Nevada State Athletic Commission has banned testosterone replacement therapy from boxing and MMA. Now, Floyd Mayweather, I said this in earlier videos before they banned it, because I knew. You use common sense. You have to use common sense. I said this way before it happened, that Floyd Mayweather is on testosterone replacement therapy. I guarantee it. And here's how I know. Two quick signs. Firstly, he's 37 years old, and when your body gets to 37 years old, you're not producing enough testosterone to be a boxer, right? You're not producing enough testosterone to look like you were in your 20s. So he needs to get on that synthetic testosterone, the replacement, to boost his testosterone levels. And it was legal, right? And then in Nevada State Athletic Commission, they'll let high profile boxers be anonymous, right? It's a private exemption, which means they don't have to make it public. So I believe privately Mayweather was, you know, on TRT. Now, another thing is that he's kind of giving himself away by not selecting his venue. And I think, hold on. Oh yeah, back to what I was, all right, I lost my train of thought, but now I've got it back. The two signs that he's on it are two things. I already told you the first sign is the fact that he's 37 years old, right? Now the second sign, this is just me using common sense. If you look at some of his interviews in, I don't know, 2010, 2009, I think the perfect interview to look at is the 2009 interview press conference pre-fight of Juan Manuel Marquez and Floyd Mayweather. If you look at the pre-fight conference, you'll see that his voice is regular, right? His voice is normal. Then if you go to a recent interview with the Canelo fight or the Guerrero, you'll notice that his voice is discernibly deeper. And when I say deeper, I mean it's pretty obvious. It sounds like he's going through puberty. His voice is cracking and it's very deep. So his voice is discernibly deeper. You'll notice that in recent interviews his voice is cracking and stuff. So that right there should be, you should use common sense, right, to put two and two together. To me it's pretty obvious. When you're talking millions and millions of dollars on the line, he's gonna do that. But another thing that was very odd about the, or I think another reason that Mayweather liked fighting in Nevada, for two reasons. They allowed him to inject xylothane in his arm, in his hands, because he's known in his career for breaking his hands and having hand problems. So Nevada's the one state that allowed that. Other states banned it. Another reason that he was fighting in Nevada is because in Nevada, they allow a boxer or MMA fighter testosterone levels to be 4-1. You understand what that means? That means 4-1 means the average, that means it's like four times the average of what it's supposed to be. So they let him have it to 4-1, which is crazy. That's very high. No other state allows that high, that ratio that high. So that's another reason. And so you should just think twice when he goes around accusing people of steroids, because I believe that he's on the best performance-enhancing drugs on the planet. He's taking the best stuff that you could get, because you're talking millions of dollars. You're talking, you're just talking so much money on the line that of course he's going to do something like that. You know, you have to expect it. Another thing that I just want to, before I wrap this up, Chino Maidana, right? Before Mayweather selected his opponent, there was a pausing, there was a in limbo moment, right? Where he was weighing his options. Was it going to be Khan? Was it going to be Maidana? Well, it turns out Chino Maidana's manager, Sebastian Contorsi, was called in from Al Haymon for an urgent meeting, right? So this manager had to go from Argentina, fly out to where Al Haymon is, which I think is Las Vegas. And that's when they made the deal. Now, if you want to be conspiracy theorists, here's what I think happened. They said, look, we're going to give Maidana this much money, to fight Mayweather, which I would guess it would be like $2 million, right? Let's just say $2 million, right? Now, when there's millions of dollars on the line, you know, look at Floyd Mayweather's purse. It's going to be, I guess, $40 million, $50 million. His last one was $100 million. So why does it make sense, business sense, to take some of that million from Mayweather's purse? I don't know what it would be, like $2 million, an extra $2 million, an extra $4 million. I don't know what it could be. And offer it to Maidana to lose, right? Because if Maidana wins, he's ruining the apple cart, because Mayweather will get millions in future fights. Do you understand? So it makes more sense to buy him off, right? To pay Chino off, right? Because when you think about it, it just makes more sense. Because now it's an investment. You're investing a little bit of money in Chino to pay him off, right? Because I think the most Chino ever made was not even $1 million. So if you're giving this guy multiple millions, I think he's going to say yeah, because he's been fighting since 2004. You know, his career is over. This is his one big opportunity to make a lot of money. I mean, I don't see why he doesn't take the payoff from Mayweather or Al Haymon, whoever does it, and then also bet on Mayweather secretly. You know, have somebody bet a bunch of money on Mayweather. So that's what I see. I think that it makes more sense for him to buy off Maidana, because it just makes more sense, because you're talking millions of dollars. And another reason, this is just putting two to two together. Floyd Mayweather has said this quote. He said, "I am boxing. I am the sport. I'm bigger than the sport." You know what that means? That means that if boxing is corrupt, right? Boxing is a corrupt sport. They call it the prostitute of sports. If Mayweather is saying, "I am that," what is that saying? He's saying, "I am corrupt." Right? That's just using logic right there. If he's saying, "I am boxing," that's saying, and boxing is corrupt, that means he is saying, "I am corrupt." So I don't think that, you know, this is going to be a fair fight. I think that it's going to be a rigged, fixed match. And don't buy the pay-per-view. Don't buy it, because another thing that gave it away that it's a rigged match is Floyd Mayweather was tweeting, after Maidana, he was tweeting to Khan. He said, "If you fight Adrian Broner on my undercard, I will fight you in September," or whatever, right? So he's just totally saying that he's got Maidana in the bank, right? So it makes sense, man. Look, just think about it. Millions and millions of dollars on the line. Millions of dollars on the line. And not only that, but if Mayweather is making these crazy purses, and he wants to continue to make more, he could better his chances. I think what they're going to tell Maidana is, instead of fighting hard, it's going to be like they're going to tell him, make it a sparring match, Maidana. You know, try to don't go full blast like you're trying to take his head off. Just go be in sparring mode, like a hard sparring session. I think that's what is gonna happen, you know. And I really hope it's not true, because I love the sport. I love being the fan, and I love watching it. But I wouldn't put it past him, man. I really wouldn't. You know, it makes more sense for him to do that, because now because if he loses his guaranteed purse, right? Because since Mayweather's undefeated, he has a guaranteed purse as long as he's undefeated. So as soon as he loses, he's gonna lose that guaranteed amount. So his money's gonna lower. So to me, it's just business sense. You know, you pay off a guy a little bit of what you're gonna get right now for future fights. It's just an investment. It's like an insurance. So what do you think, man? I really hope I'm wrong. I mean, I really, really hope I'm wrong, because it's just making me cynical in a way, and I really don't want to be that way, you know. Because when I first started boxing, I was very optimistic. But over the years, I'm kind of getting more hardened about it, more jaded. So I don't know. Let me know what you think, man. I hope I'm wrong. What is your take? That's what I really want to know. What is your take on this? Peace out.